Hey everybody, today on Heart and Soul, take the meat out of your soul food. We'll tell you how. And do you want to spruce up your workout wardrobe? It only takes a few simple steps. And singer Erykah Badu gives her take on beauty, health, and Hollywood. We're bringing you this dazzling edition of Heart and Soul from DC's Tiny Jewel Box. Stay tuned.
And I'm Dr. Rowe. Welcome to Heart and Soul. Now today we're coming to you from the Tiny Jewel Box in downtown DC. Now don't be fooled by the name. The Tiny Jewel features three marvelous floors of diamonds and rubies and pearls. Oh my. Now we're going to show you some of the hottest ice you've ever seen, but first we get started with the show.
Our first story answers a question that I get asked all the time. What exactly is my training routine?
Yeah, what exactly is it?
Well, now the secret is out. Heart and Soul's own Sita went all the way down to Florida with me as I participated in the Miss Galaxy competition.
Each week, you get to see Heart and Soul's very own Mocha Lee not only host Heart and Soul, but looking good and staying fit. Now, as the producer of the show, I got to tell you, she gets letters, she gets emails, she gets phone calls. Everybody wants to know, how does she do it? Well, guess what? Today is your lucky day. You get to see just how Mocha stays fit. This is the Miss Galaxy Competition's obstacle course in St. Pete Beach, Florida, where Mocha Lee is defending her title. Everybody wants to know how my girl Mocha looks so darn good. First of all, before we get into the Miss Galaxy competition, okay, how do you do it?
I've always enjoyed exercise, and it just became a part of my life, a part of my day. Then after college, I became certified to teach aerobics and personal train, and so after my 9-to-5 job, I would always be at the gym doing that as a, you know, secondary job. So once I realized I really just liked the gym scene, I was like, well, shoot, if I'm still in here training all the time, I may as well go ahead and do a competition. There have been times when I've had like more body fat than I want, and I had to learn how to get that under control to be able to compete at a level like this.
Mocha, what makes training for this competition better than just, say, working out on a regular routine every day?
Well, you know what it is? There are a lot of people like me who just need something to really push them. You know, I need a goal. What is it that's going to really motivate you and make you drive and want to get up and be like, oh no, I got to work out today? And it's a competition like this where you put yourself under the pressure of knowing on this day I'm going to be out there in front of all these people, so I have to train. And it's cool because in the meantime, you know, you're staying in shape.
So ladies, if you're trying to get a body like Mocha's, find a competition, find a marathon, get involved in something. So what about, we talked about the physical part, but what about nutrition? How does that play a part in how you stay looking the way you look?
Once you realize that you're going for the aesthetics of it, how you actually look, you have to learn about nutrition and don't eat a lot of carbohydrates like bread and pasta late at night, because that's what will kind of turn into fat and sit on your stomach. All those little things like protein is what feeds your muscles, and you start to learn about that, and then you just get into the habit of eating that way, drinking a lot of water.
Homegirl carries around a gallon of water every day. Everywhere she goes, she's got her little gallon of water, okay?
Gotta
Why
drink
is that
up.
So important?
The reason it's important to keep yourself hydrated, and for most people 8 to 10 glasses is cool, but it's because water helps you flush your system. It helps you stay just energized, and actually water is a natural appetite suppressant. So if you're sipping all the time, then you're less likely to be hungry and just nibble on junk.
A lot of people might think that's all you eat are carrots and celery sticks and protein bars. But do you eat real food?
I do, and I think what's important for people to understand is that your body is like an engine and you have to fuel yourself. So for me, because I work out a lot, I have to eat a lot. So it's not big meals, but it's little meals. So say like 5 little meals throughout the day.
Do you ever find yourself like pigging out on, let's say, fried chicken and french fries?
You busted me. Yeah, every now and then I do. And especially, you know, at family functions, forget it. All my relatives can cook. So at Thanksgiving and, you know, cookouts, I go ahead.
You make sacrifices throughout the year so that you can have those times.
Exactly.
Where you can enjoy certain things.
Exactly.
No, Mo, I've got to ask, is it as hard as it looks?
Girl, whew, that and more.
Okay, here's a question for you. Does your makeup bag need a little makeover?
Heart and Soul's own Jay Ende tells us how your makeup bag can look as together as your face.
We wear makeup to enhance our beauty, but using dirty brushes, bent brushes, and old makeup only means trouble.
If the inside of your makeup bag looks like this, that can't be good. We have a skincare specialist, Jermaine, who's going to tell us why our bag shouldn't look like this.
Hygienically, it's not very good. It's not clean, it's not sanitary, and in terms of keeping your products nice, it really makes them go bad a lot sooner.
This sister's about to commit a definite makeup no-no. She shouldn't even think about using that old smelly mascara. Freeze!
So a person should really be replenishing their mascara every 3 months. What will happen if you keep it too long, bacteria will grow. The person can develop a sty or maybe pink eye, and in worst case scenarios, maybe a cyst on the eye.
Chances are if your eyeliner is this small, it's time to get rid of it.
Most definitely, and they. One of the dangers with this eyeliner is it actually could scrape the eyelid or the corner of the eye. So you really want to discard it and just get a new one.
She's at it again. Don't you dare put that sponge on your precious face. Freeze!
Cosmetic sponges are very porous, so they hold a lot of dirt and debris and bacteria. So a person, when a sponge looks like this, you definitely want to discard it because it could cause rashes on the skin, in some cases acne.
When your favorite lipstick color gets this low, don't use your fingers to dig it out and apply it to your lips. After all, your hands may not be so clean. Try using a disposable lipstick brush or just buy a new tube. And no matter how much your friend asks, don't share lipstick.
If the person maybe has a cold or even a cold sore, it could stay on the lipstick and chances are you could catch that.
Now, what if you're pulling a brush out? Ooh, you see all that?
Yes. Exactly.
The brush is bad too, right?
If you are using the brushes on a regular basis, you do want to make sure that you're cleansing the brushes at least twice a month with a mild detergent such as baby shampoo.
Here's Jermaine's product safety timeline. Liquid eyeliners and mascara are only good for 3 months after you open them. Pressed powder typically has a shelf life of 3 to 5 years, but you should change the sponge very often. Lipstick can last 3 to 5 years, but remember, no lipstick sharing. And if you can't pay attention to the time, Jermaine says please pay attention to the smell.
Usually products that have exceeded their shelf life will have smell like clay or Play-Doh, and that kind of lets you know that the product has gone bad.
So you want to use your nose, your sense of time, and just some common sense to clean that makeup bag up.
Yeah.
Oh, you caught us. Okay, thanks, Jay and Day. Next, we'll show you meat-free meals that even a meat eater would love.
And you can be fit and fly while you're working out. We'll show you how. Stay right there.
This program is sponsored by Monistat, the number one doctor-recommended brand for the treatment of yeast infections.
For any woman who's ever suffered from a yeast infection, relief can't come soon enough. We hear you. Introducing a new Monistat 3 combination pack with a separate cream that starts to relieve the burning itch immediately. Other treatments may keep you waiting for up to 24 hours. The new Monistat 3 combination pack. It does more than cure the infection. It silences the symptoms. Monistat. Fast relief from the number one doctor-recommended brand.
The importance of an African-American book club is to pass a legacy on. Well, back in slavery, it was against the law for us to read.
I had always read black authors. When I came here, I realized the importance of reading black authors, too.
Reading and being in an African-American book club has impacted our children a great deal.
It makes me feel good when I give a book to a child and they can see themselves and they say, this is what I want to do.
When did you folks see the light?
On a trip to my sister's, I said, why waste money when we can stay at Motel 6, didn't I, hon? Now see what happens when you listen. It's like that fear he had of cauliflower wouldn't go near the produce.
Call us and see the light for yourself.
Everyone loves Domino's delicious cheesy bread. Maybe because it's hot breadsticks covered in a tantalizing combination of cheddar and mozzarella cheeses. Who would come up with such a brilliant idea?
My idea. All mine.
And if you call now, you can get a delicious order of cheesy bread free. That's right, free when you buy a large one-topping pizza for $9.99. Now, where do you suppose that idea came from?
My idea. All mine.
Make it a meal with wings and a 2-liter Coke. Get the door. It's Domino's.
Hey, you like delivery pizza? I like delivery pizza.
It's not delivery. It's... It's French.
For fresh baked pizza at home, it's not delivery, it's DiGiorno.
Papa loves Mambo. Mama loves Mambo. Look at him sway with it, getting so gay with it, shouting ole with it, wow.
Papa loves Mambo.
Mambo, Papa.
Mama loves Mambo.
Mambo, Mama.
Don't play the rumba, don't play the samba.
Papa
loves the Mambo tonight.
BET Event Productions presents the Durban Jazz Festival, September 22nd and 23rd in beautiful Durban, South Africa. You'll enjoy electrifying talent, game reserves, and the exotic surroundings of Durban. Come experience the music of Dave Koz, Ronnie Jordan, Brenda Russell, Carl Thomas, Najee, B.B. Winans, and many more. To book your Durban Jazz Festival vacation, call South African Airways at 1-866-359-7225 or call Alkin Tours at 1-800-327-9974.
Welcome back. Now, if diamonds are a girl's best friend, then we're definitely in the right spot. We're in DC's tiny jewel box. Now, I'm wearing custom tanzanite. The stone tanzanite comes from Tanzania.
And I'm wearing jewelry that could be fit for a queen. This diamond and emerald bracelet originally belonged to Italian royalty, and it can be yours for a mere $62,000.
Not too shabby. Now, more of you are adopting vegetarian lifestyles, and it can be a healthy alternative if you just get a little creative.
Heart and Soul's own Andre gives us vegetarian dishes that will make you green with envy.
What do these high-profile celebs have in common? Yes, all of them are talented entertainers, but there's something else they share in common. Each of them is a vegetarian. Meat and poultry are common soul food fare, but Americans are now opting for meat-free meals at record numbers. Some do it for the health benefits. Others do it for social or religious reasons.
More and more of you are saying no to meat, and here's what I mean. The Vegetarian Times says there are 15 million Americans who call themselves vegetarians, and that number keeps growing and growing and growing each year.
To be part of the Vegetarian Club, it's important to know just where you fit in. Semi-vegetarians make up the largest group. They don't eat meat, but they basically eat everything else, including fish and poultry. Next, lacto-ovo-vegetarians. They don't eat meat, fish, or poultry. Ovo-vegetarians don't eat meat, fish, poultry, or dairy products. Lacto-vegetarians are the next type. Their do-not-eat list includes meat, fish, shellfish, poultry, and eggs, but they do eat dairy products. And our last group is vegan. They have the most restrictive diet because they don't eat meat, fish, shellfish, poultry, dairy products, or eggs.
Some people think that they're vegetarian, so that means they're healthy, but they can still be overweight and suffer some of the same health issues as people who aren't vegetarians. Isn't that true?
It is so true, particularly for our teenagers. Many of our teenagers are actually eating French fries, swapping the meat with something that's not healthy. And the key here is to make sure that if you do plan to enjoy a vegetarian meal, that it is prepared in a healthy way.
A lot of vegetarians get bored with their food, so they end up piling up their carts with a lot of snacks and fatty foods. But there's one quick way to make sure you stay on track. Remember, don't cut out the flavor just because you cut out the meat. So eating vegetarian doesn't mean it has to be boring.
No, vegetarian meat eating, just like anything else, needs some imagination, some preparation, and some challenge.
Okay, here's a challenge for you. We recruited Ken and Kai, two diehard meat eaters, for a taste test of vegetarian cuisine from Delights of the Garden restaurant in Washington, D.C. We'll check back with these two in a moment, but first the chef tells us how to stir it up vegetarian style.
Many persons have learned to cook things, and so you can have raw vegetarian food, you can have lightly sauteed, lightly marinated, you can have barbecue. I mean, so the possibilities are almost unlimited. Really, people just have to broaden their horizons and open up their minds.
With minds open, our meat lovers, Ken and Kai, are now ready to give us the scoop on meatless meals. First up, Kai samples the burrito wrap filled with cushion sprouts instead of beef and beans. So how's the taste?
The wrap is very good. I thought I would miss the chicken or the beef, but I don't at all. It's very tasty. It's good.
Next, Ken tries the veggie patty made from soybeans.
Excellent, excellent. I'm a hearty meat eater, but the patty replaces all the meat. Good taste.
The vegetable patty is very good. It's not missing any of the spices. I love it.
So far, so good. Now time for dessert. We have banana cake and apple pie made with raw apples. Now, that didn't sound too appealing to Ken, but I think the taste won him over.
I thought it would bother him, but not at all. Same good taste, same fruit taste, natural.
So whether or not you decide to go vegetarian or hold on to your meat-eating ways, you might want to begin your journey with a prayer.
A special prayer for Mother Joe, who has provided for the Roman Isles of Rapid beautiful breasts and delicious legs on the table. Lord, all I'm asking is bless this bread, bless this meat, and bless my stomach, cause I was going to eat.
Amen. Amen to that, and amen to good eating.
Coming up next, Erykah Badu as you've never seen her before, and look cute at the gym without breaking a sweat. Cause I was right there at his grave. Enjoy something made better with time. Slow Roast Coffee from Maxwell House. It's worth spending time with.
Hey guys, when did you see the light?
On our last fishing trip. I mean, just flashed over me. Stay at Motel 6. Hey, I'm no fool. Save big bucks and slept like a baby.
Yeah, like a big old snoring baby.
Call us and see the light for yourself.
They're facing so much in this world. I want them to make the right decisions, to be strong. And I want them to hold on to this joy forever.
If you're searching for something to believe in, for your children to believe in, our hearts, our minds, and our doors are always open. The people of the United Methodist Church.
Hold of Rock This, 32 massive rock hits on two CDs or two cassettes. Crazy on you. Crazy on you. I'm burning for you. You can order this collection online at musicspace.com. Get this 32-track collection in any store. Order by credit card now and get a free Rock This poster. You want something to rock? Then Rock This. To order, have your credit card ready and call the number on your screen or log on to musicspace.com.
It's important to have a regular fitness routine, that you already know. But it's also nice if you can look good while you're working out. Heart and Soul's own Cedar shows us how to whip your body and wardrobe into shape all at the same time.
This is my workout home, but today, I'm just not feeling it.
Hey, Cedar, how you doing today?
Hey, Marie, I'm not doing too good. I'm tired.
You look kind of tired. What's going on?
I don't know. It's not one of them days.
Well, let me tell you, workout is really, really important. Mm-hmm. But along with the workout, sometimes how we dress will affect how we feel. So I tell you what today we're going to do. We're going to get dressed in some funky outfits to go with a new attitude to motivate us and get us going on our workout. Okay?
Okay,
come on, let's go get dressed. Okay?
All right.
Now it's time for us to get moving. And just like Marie Johnson, manager of World Gym, says, a funky outfit can motivate you into a great workout. Check out this baby tee by Body by Most Designs and Nike spandex shorts. Not only are they comfortable, but stylish too. Here's Marie sporting this two-piece cotton outfit by Hotskins. And if you don't feel comfortable in the revealing tank top, it also comes with a jacket. This Adidas outfit was one of my favorites. I started off with a spandex tank top and comfy capris. Boo boo. It's not just urban street gear, but Marie looks great in this three-piece athletic sweatsuit. And if wearing the jacket feels like too much, hey, take it off. Strike a pose with Baby Fat. They too are known for their urban gear, but they also carry fly fitness gear. Here's yet another great outfit made by Hotskins. It's fitting, but thanks to the jacket, it's not too revealing. And instead of buying new shoes to match all your gear, check out these replaceable color tabs, which can easily be inserted onto the sides of Cheers athletic shoes. Sporty, huh? So remember, a fly outfit can not only help you make a statement at the gym, but motivate your workout.
Thanks, Sita. Take a look at any newsstand, and you're sure to find singer Erykah Badu on any one of the covers. Well, when we come back, Erykah opens up about how she handles life at home and life in the public eye, if you just stay put.
The importance of an African American book club is to pass a legacy on.
Well, back in slavery, it was against the law for us to read.
I hadn't always read black authors. When I came here, I realized the importance of reading black authors, too.
Reading and being in an African-American book club has impacted our children a great deal.
It makes me feel good when I give a book to a child and they can see themselves and they say, this is what I want to do.
You know, Capri Sun's all natural, which means I can pronounce everything in it. And ever since they made it easy open, the kids inhale it.
Easy open Capri Sun.
Yeah! Oh!
Great pizza. Who delivered?
Well, it's not delivery.
Mm-hmm. This is delivery.
Wanna bet?
For fresh baked pizza at home, it's not delivery. It's DiGiorno.
Dawson, sir. Lost another bet.
When did you folks see the light?
On a trip to my sister's, I said, why waste money when we can stay at Motel 6, didn't I, hon? Now see what happens when you listen. It's like that fear he had of cauliflower wouldn't go near the produce.
Call us and see the light for yourself.
Scratch below the surface, and everyone has a story.
This is my life track.
Life Track, Wednesday nights at 8, only on BET.
Shining stuff for you to see.
All new this fall, BET's rolling out the red carpet and brand new primetime shows premiere week. Tuesdays at 8, Spike Davis tests game show contestants' knowledge of music and pop culture with On the Beat, followed by How I'm Living. Check out the cars, homes, and lifestyles of black stars. Wednesdays at 8, Life Track shows you that black stars don't have to be celebrities, followed by Oh Drama. The ladies are still dishing the dirt, but with a new face and a new place. Then Thursday, BET blows the roof off premiere week with The Way We Do It, a hot new variety show hosted by Ricky Smiley, showing you the funny. But that's not all. It's Comet View's 10th anniversary, this time from the Bayou every night at 10. All new BET Primetime every night at 8, starting September 17th.
Your life can truly be. Welcome back. Erykah Badu is one of the hottest gems ever to hit the R&B scene. She's got a string of new hits, and her latest album is already causing a buzz in the industry. I am so glad you told me to buy that CD.
Okay, may I just tell you that I listen in the car, I listen at home, everywhere. I recommend you go out and get it. Now, you may wonder how this singer-actress mom wears so many hats without losing her head. Well, here's where you find out.
My will is strong as my body. It's been done from the beginning of time. It ain't nothing new that I'm doing. We built like this. I'm a vegan vegetarian, so I eat healthy foods, raw foods if possible. As much as I can, I drink fresh juices, fresh squeezed juices, fruit and veggies. The excess body fat dropped off when I started, when I became a vegetarian. Ideas to me seem to flow quicker to my brain, but I try to do 30 push-ups a day, about 3 sets, you know, during the day. My son is 3 years old. And hey, Sapa, hey, Seven. He's 3 years old, and he keeps me running back and forth. He's very active. It's a very difficult task to have a small child and a career that's pretty demanding, you know, a schedule that's really demanding. I guess I balance it by having a lot of good, concerned people around, like my mother, grandmother, my sister, girlfriends that helped me with Seven. What am I supposed to do when I want you in the world? Something that's really good, ladies and guys and kids, is to have a couple of moments a day to sit and just listen, you know? And that's really good food. I mean, just let everybody else talk, or just whatever's happening around you, just have a silent fast at least once a day. And that really helps you to stay focused and balanced. The best juice to relieve stress is turnip and beet greens. It's a little, give you a little buzz. Remember that turnip and beet greens is good for that time of the month when your estrogen level has overdid itself, too, ladies. Turnip and beet green juice can get you high. Make sure you take risks, you know, try out different colors and different things, different hairstyles, different braiding styles, different textures of clothes and different lotions, and treat yourself to something beautiful every once in a while because we deserve it. But I can't stand life without you. Now me and baby got this situation. I can't really describe, you know, what it is that turns me on about fashion, but I love to look like a dancer, you know, because I've been a dancer since I was about 4 years old. And all of this stuff, you know, the way that this top is, and it's all dance, you know, and I like to look like a dancer. I just wanted to be you and me like it you used to be, baby, but you don't. So matter of fact, I think you better call Tyrone. If you find yourself making someone else responsible for your happiness, then maybe you need to check that, because you're the only one responsible for it. So deal with it. March, soldiers.
It's been real. We've had a ball here at the Tiny Jewel Box, but we gotta go.
Now, join us next week at another exciting location, because you never know where we might turn up next. Until then, be safe
and be healthy.
Bye. Welcome back. Now, diamonds are a girl's best friend, and you've gotta stop rustling that.
Heart and Soul's own Andre. Sorry. Don't do that. Don't look at me mean.
Now today we're coming to you from the Tiny Jewel. in downtown D.C. Now, don't let the word fool you. Tiny. We'll do it again. All right, here's a question for you. Does your makeup bag need a little makeover?
Hi, I'm Oka Lee.
And I'm welcome. I'm Dr. Rowe.
Heart and Soul's own Sita went all the way down to Florida with me as I participated in the heart, oh, God.